Welcome to the Startup Grind.
Thank you all for coming tonight. It's great to see you, great to meet you as well, especially people which I haven't met before, so thank you for that. Tonight, I'll just say a little bit about what the event is and a little bit about the speaker as well. So first, about the event. The event is called Startup Grind. It's the world's largest entrepreneur community. It's sponsored by Google for Entrepreneurs. We do have other sponsors in different cities as well. And we have around 1,000 entrepreneurs as members. We have great investor success stories. And then when they first came, we did a talk for Wales, and now we have international events. Some of our good people as well, because we have people that spend more than 4 or 5 million. That's really helping people on their versions from the events as well. How we suffer. So I'll speak into this. As PJD, a public national, he moved to Cardiff, and he's got such a fantastic record and experience, which I'm sure everyone will benefit from listening and learning about the speaker. So he's got such experience in terms of starting a business. He just started a business, a new business last week. He just started with his son and another partner as well. So he's got a fantastic story, and also having an international background. So I'm looking forward to listening to what he's got to say and to learn more about his story as well. So can you please stand up, give a big warm welcome to JB Lantrange, please. Woo! Welcome. How are you?
Good, good.
Excellent.
Good.
Good to see you. How is your journey so far to arrive here? Was it easy or how?
Yes, it was easy. I was working in Berlin, so I had my last meeting with John Booth, so I was quite home.
Cool, yeah. Yes, so some transition.
Yeah.
By the way, the speakers, we start out to know more about your job and it is the joy when you learn like that.
Yeah, so I'm building here at the Sonos of France, close to Nice. And I lived there for 20 years. And I really enjoyed the skiing and ski up the mountains. It's quite an interesting place. And we have the sun and the Mediterranean, so I like the sailing also. So I did a lot of sailing and a lot of skiing. I done all my secondary education over there, and then I moved to Paris to finish my hotel education. So my life when I was young was pretty easy. I've been raised by my grandmother, and she was a fantastic lady. I learned a lot from her, and she has been my model with the listening, so I really miss her. But after that, we moved to Paris. It was heartbreaking for her because I left her, and I got a dream and market and that business. I worked for them for about 10 years and I've been recruited by Motorola. And I was in finance with Motorola for 16 years and moved in general management position. And say that you have to go back to the UK because all of my kids have been back raised in the UK. So I say, oh, you can send your family back to the UK, you can have a community. Actually, I was saying, well, I know what to do that. And then you know, I am in the package with that.
First, and they were not able to
takes the technology also, to understand it. So pretty quickly we had to change our mind and go to strategy, because I started that when I was doing around the chance to have a real theme of it was fascinating to see how they were working. So coming from a large company and going into the SME world, I could make my mind how to be consulted to. And then I really started to work on how does it work, what does it do, what is the mentality about that. So I started to do a lot of psychological and sociological research on how SMEs are working, so I could help them because I could work. And by doing that, I learned a lot on how to grow my own business. So basically in 2005, I was with my friend, still enjoying him. Well, we were bored, you know, we were only two of us, and we were used to being in an international environment. So we cannot carry on like that, you know, we will be bored before we know it. And so he says, well, what can we do then? So well, we have to go on the network of concerns so that we can actually change the environment and see what we can do with a network of people involved in international networks, CNN and management consulting and corporate finance. What is really good in executive search and in internal management? You know, like far, but management consulting and corporate finance. So I started this team in Wales of seven consultants. And we developed new products and we need to talk to people and to approach them. And then we said, well, we don't have a lot of support from the headquarters. Why are we needing to be there? So I approached them and I said, well, basically, we don't really like management consultants, we don't really like corporate finance. Why don't I buy your network? So we agreed to buy the network. They didn't want us to keep the CNA International name, so we had to find them, call it any consulting international, so that people were not too disturbed by the name change. Don't ask me what that means. We had to find the identification of it, which was that meaningful advice. That was also my network that was and that I got through the head to see that I got through the head. To try to understand the motivation in the network, what we are doing, their qualification, how they are working, and things like that. Because I'm very conscious of quality and customer service. And to me, that is more important than anything else. So I didn't like what I saw. So I fired that another one. So we had a very small team. We grew back in 5 years, we grew back to Hamburg, and then we are now around 2020. So, not quite to see 135, I created a bit of, but very good quality consultants. I decided that it was not good to be only in the UK, so I used my connection with Motorola, and I went to Chicago. Spent 2 months there and contacted all my friends. myself with an English engineer. Based in Chicago, and now we have prosecutors in California and Florida, in New York, has been a fascinating journey last year. Somebody who has virtually talked to me, the events, and eventually I think
I became the chairman of the chapter, of one chapter, and that made
we know a lot of people, so we can contact with a lot of people. Then being approached by the president of the Calvary Chamber of Commerce, Nigel Roberts, and Nigel said that we are in a different position financially, politically. So, no, they said, well, I will come and do an export meeting. And so it's an issue that we need to go with that today. We will care that. I went to the officer and cannot do this, not dead, but for sure.
How long was this?
It was in 2005 or something. And so we have a Kenny John the board and help us to rescue his woman. So I can actually rescue the company, but we have to get rid of his debt in a way or another. So we approached the Welsh government and said, well, we have this huge debt, there is no way we can reimburse you. What do you want to do with that? So we will be supporting you, don't worry. You will be reimbursed when you will be back. So fantastic. And then I was on the board of the bank. So I worked with them quite a lot. Met a lot of people also being on the board of the county chamber. Because they asked me to go and talk to people, and I was in every event that we are doing. So I met a lot of people, and that was good for my business. I mean, to be honest, you know, I was not doing that just out of attitude. I was doing that because it was a good thing too. So it has been very good for me, but until I find very, very quick the Welsh market, and it's very now only the Welsh market, you are in a very good market. So they want to do I get to go out as a half or I get my network to get in contact with people in London, with people in France, with people in Bratislava, and that's how it's a company moved.
And the same thing was about the challenge.
Basically, what I've been asked about two years ago, exactly 2 years ago, to become the president of the Alliance Française. I don't know if you were aware of the Alliance Française. The Alliance Française is a network of people educating in the French culture and French language, and promoting the French language and the French culture. So there is about 130 Alliance Française in the world, it's a foundation is in Paris, and it's sponsored by the French government, but it's not part of the French government, it's sponsored by there, and it's part of the French Institute. So basically, I was asked if I can help to sit under the branch because I like that. did this and then I said, well, we have to stop that. Fortunately, we realigned in 77 and a bit. And still, some of our values in these days, without some of them still have to or probably so, I was not doing that. Fortunately, we had two, we had the Afghan process that we do a charity. We had a French center that was the non-profit organization. So, we decided to go back on the to French center. And to the Afghan process, which helped us a lot, not our filters, unfortunately. But we rescued the Alliance Française, which is now growing quite significantly. We have about 40 students on a permanent basis. We still have to grow more than that. We present films on French films. We are in a chapter. To do that, and we do a lot of events on French culture also, so those of you who want to taste in cooking in France, and we are moving now into handling business to understand how to do business in France or in French culture. It's very, very different than France. So there is quite a lot of fictions. And I have to put some hours to make them work together. But that's good because you know now we can learn from that and explain to businesses the difference between living business in France and living business here and try to help them to reconcile.
So what would be your best advice for